Hello students, good morning. Today we will see the third constraint, not null, and the fourth constraint, check. Not null is a constraint which can be used only with column level. It can be used in table level syntax. It is used in column level syntax, that is create table student class number, I can give primary key, okay, class number int primary key, class number int primary key, comma, name character 10. I can give a constraint here as not null, not null. Okay, this means that while entering value to the field name, there should be value. We cannot skip the value by selective insertion. How can we do selective insertion? Insert into table, inside brackets we can give the columns to which we have to insert data. That is selective insertion. Insert into student, inside bracket we can give the field names. Then give values and corresponding names, corresponding values. Okay, so that is selective insertion. So while we are doing insertion, either selective or non-selective, the value for the name should be supplied. This is what we call not null constraint. Okay, so not null is a constraint demanding a value to be entered in that field. Demanding a value to be entered in that field. Okay. It can be repetitive values because we have not given unique there. We can combine both constraints here also. Unique space not null. It means that the value should be unique and the value should not be null also. So we can combine two constraints in a single field also. This is not null. Okay. One more, this is not a constraint, but we have a keyword called default. So in some textbooks, they are called as constraint also, but default is actually not a constraint because it does not have any restrictions on values. Default is the value which is stored by default if the user is not supplying the values. That is default. This is like a function, default function parameter in C++. So default is the default fields will be having a default value. For that we can give create a table student, okay, class number int, okay, name character 10, comma, grade or status character 5. I am giving as default pass. So this is the syntax for giving a default value. What is the use? By insertion, if we do not supply values to this field status, then the value stored will be passed there. Okay, we will try this in our SQL. Okay, copy. Okay, where is that? Create table student class number in primary key, name character 10, not null. So we have the not null constraint here. Describe student. Okay. So while inserting values, we should insert values. That we have this not null constraint. Okay, we will drop this table. Drop table student. Drop table student. And we will create that. We will use that second query for default access. So create table student class number int. Okay, name character 10, status character 5, default pass. Okay, so this means that the default value insert will be pass. We'll try for the selective insertion. Insert into student to which fields? To class number and name fields only, and the values are class number is 1, name is Arun. Okay, this is selective insertion. Even though the table contains 3 fields, we can insert values to 2 fields. Okay, so this is selective insertion. Select star from student. Okay, you can see the default value as pass. So if you do not supply value to this field, the default value obtained or stored there, it is the default value given, that is pass. This is the use of default keyword. Okay, so we have seen not null and default. Now we will see what is check constraint. Check constraint can also be used in column level, table level, and a table level with name. Okay, so I will show how to use check constraint. So check constraint is a create table student class number int. Okay, name character 10 comma marks integer. Here I am going to give the check constraint, marks int check constraint. Check, then what is the check? Marks should be greater than 30. So this is how we create check constraint. Okay, so this is how we do check constraint. So when values are inserted to this marks field, it should satisfy the condition. It should be greater than 30. Okay, that is check constraint. So check constraint can be given either using column level constraint or by table level constraint. That is create table like this. Okay, then after defining all the fields, put a comma, then give check marks greater than 30. Okay, this is table level and this is comma. You can give a name, constraint t3 check marks greater than 30. So this is the third syntax, having a name for the constraint. What is the use of name? You can delete the constraint by using alter table drop check t3. Okay, like that you can delete the constraint added to the table. Alter table drop, the constraint name is check, so drop check t3. If we give drop check only, then all the check constraints will be deleted. If I give drop check t3, then the t3 will be deleted. Okay, so these are three different syntax: table level, sorry, column level, table level, and table level with a name. So we have seen three things in here. One is not null, other is default, and other is check constraint. Default can be termed as constraint, but it is not a restriction. It is a default value given to the table during selective insertion. Okay. Okay. See you in the next class. Thank you.